Well, and thanks for joining me here in my shop. This would be video number two on what I think is going to be a fairly short series on this amplifier. So I wanted to put a speaker on it. For the first time, I took a moment and measured the resistance of my speakers. They're only 4 ohms. So although there's 2 plugs that have come with it, I'm only going to plug in 1 speaker. Because these plugs are simply in parallel. If I put 2 4-ohm speakers in parallel, we're down to 2 ohms. That's getting down a little low. Yeah. some interesting sounds in the background. What a sad situation. Okay. Just try to ignore that. Oh my gosh. Okay, I think everything's all better now, and we're just about set here. Oh, I need an input. Cable to plug that in. Plug it in when we're ready. Okay, the volume is down, but the switch is on. Hey, it's live TV out of my basement. What can I tell you? You never know what's going to happen here. Okay, so we're all set. Almost. Okay, I think we're ready to give this a try. I'll keep it on the 2-bulb protection. Here we go. Faint bulb glow, and I think what that suggests to me is that some of these capacitors held their charge. Okay, so you don't. Yes. What? Okay, that was one of my cats there. So we're running around 80% of the supply voltage, so that puts us in the range of 90 volts or so. I can see these bulbs have come up pretty bright now that the plate currents are flowing. Notice there's no signal, and there's enough current flowing through those tube plates to cause that. That seems a little high to me offhand. And bulbs really don't show up in the camera quite the way they do for me. Okay, let's give it a try and see what it sounds like. Just keep an eye on that. Okay, so we're going to try the phono. I believe looks like the phono and this microphone share the same control. That's this one here. And I can only guess which one of these is the master volume. Probably this one. Nothing though. Pretty sure that's going to be a tone control. Oh. Okay, I see exactly how this is wired here. So that's the phono input. Pretty hummy. There's nothing connected to it. Why the big hum? Is something not connected correctly? You know, this is, it goes right into that connection that's not soldered. I'm going to separate the, turn it off, I'm going to separate those wires right off. Because I have no idea if those are really supposed to be that way, or did somebody and do something strange here. Now the amplifier is being used. I'm pretty sure it's being used as a guitar amplifier. Do a pretty darn good job of that. Rather odd. There is solder involved in this connection. They just managed to solder two wires together, but not to the terminal. I'm just going to cut them free there. Gonna lose some floppy wire here. That. There we go. Okay. So now we have, I've just disconnected the phono terminal. You can see this resistor hanging out here. Brown, black. It looks like brown, black. Oh, yellow. It's very hard to see. I think that's brown. I can't see it. Can't see it. It looks like a large resistor here though. Again, let's just turn it on again. My guess is we'll hear nothing. We'll hear nothing from it. Just watching this meter here. Good show. The light bulbs have come up bright, the meter's dropped, plate current's flowing. Turn up this volume. There's absolutely nothing. Just as I would imagine. Now, I don't know what this resistor's doing here. Well, I'm gonna. Okay. I do have trouble talking in the evenings. That's pretty apparent. There. Okay, so that's essentially reconnected to the phono again. Hum. Very, very high impedance input is what that's indicating. Does seem a little odd. just wouldn't expect the hum to be quite that apparent. But just checking it for voltage. I would be pretty surprised to find anything here, but plug in the radio. There we go. Oh my gosh. Okay, enough already. So obviously that's working just fine. And once you plug in some kind of connector, this will be probably a 50,000 ohm impedance line. I really don't know offhand. And before plugging it in, maybe it's 1,000,000 ohms impedance. Once it's down to 50,000, and the interference, the hum, all that stuff is just not apparent anymore. So that's the story there. What's this green wire then that was also connected there? It doesn't seem to be necessary. What is it? There's no hope of getting a schematic for this. Okay, so first. Oh! Some kind of leaky capacitor connected to it, that's for sure. Yow, isn't that something? Yeah, now let's check the, we really should do this right away, the grid bias on the 6V6s. Especially since at idle, there seems to be a lot of power draw on this thing. So I'll get the 6V6. 6V6. Grid 1 is pin number 5. Grid 1 is pin number 5. The two 6V6s are here. Number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Don't see anything. Didn't hear anything. It's kind of weird. The other one. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, let me check the cathode. That's probably a smarter thing to do. 6V6. Since it probably has a resistor in the cathode circuit. 6V6. Cathode is pin number 8. So with the resistor, we'll end up seeing the bias voltage on that. Here's 8. Oh. Excuse me. Oh my gosh. That one shows 0. This one shows 13. Okay. 13. And 0 on the other one. Let's just see what the tube manual says about what it should be. 6V6. Pretty high plate voltage here. So let's use the 250 volt. It can go as high as 315, so I think it's higher than 250. Grid number 1 should be minus 12. And at the 315, it should be 13 minus 13. So I think we're right on the money with one tube, but the other tube, no. I'm not sure these tubes are in push-pull. Really? Huh. I'm not sure what to make of what's going on here. Gain is pretty tough without a schematic, so you know what I think I might do? Or things are going to get really quiet here for a while. I think I'm going to draw up the schematic around the two output tubes before I start fooling around and think I know what I'm doing. I've been doing a little bit of that lately. So thanks for watching so far.